Hi everyone, I'm Roosje and I'm the current project intern of Deveron Projects. Welcome back to another episode of the Soapbox Talks, in which I have the privilege to meet and speak with musicians from different parts of Europe. Today we make a quick trip to Romania as we are joined by Marius Mihalache and his wife Arabella, who will be the translator of the interview today. To give you a brief introduction about Marius, he is a Romanian dulcimer player, songwriter, and producer. As a teenager, he played at the opera house La Scala in Milan. He graduated in film music and songwriting at the Berklee College of Music in Boston, USA, and has written music scores for various Romanian films and TV shows. Marius has performed on many stages across the world, such as the Kennedy Center in Washington, European Parliament in Belgium, Vienna Opera in Austria, and so on. He also collaborated with renowned musicians and participated with his dulcimer in large orchestras. In 2019, he was awarded with a special prize from the Unitary Senate for his project Softisa, which is a pop folk project incorporating Romanian instruments and focusing on tales of the Romanian people, especially women, and the Romanian identity. He features in Ensemble Eòrpa with his cimbalom, a particular type of dulcimer. I want to welcome you. Hi, how are you doing? And how is Romania doing these days?
Hello, how are you?
I'm great.
Thank you very much for this interview. Next meet my wife.
Hi, Arabella.
She will translate from Romanian in English because she speak better English. That's
really excited to hear your language also in this interview. I wish I could speak Romania. I have a friend and she speaks it very beautifully, and I never got the chance to ask her how to pronounce certain things. So, let's get started.
Let's start.
Marius, you are considered to be a maestro or a magician of the cimbalom, which is a type of hammered dulcimer. Can you tell me what kind of instrument a dulcimer is and how did you get into playing this instrument?
The cimbalom or dulcimer.
You can speak in Romanian.
Take advantage of it.
Cimbalul face parte din familia instrumentelor cu corde.
The cimbalom is a part of the family of the string instruments.
Și ia naștere în urmă cu 5.000 de ani undeva în Orientul Mijlociu.
Originated 5,000 years ago somewhere in the Middle East.
Okay.
Sub o altă formă de o cutie foarte mică.
It was a trapezoidal box with several strings stretched from one to end and the other.
Unde se cânta cu degetele.
Hitting the strings with fingers.
Fie cu două bețe.
Or with two sticks.
Cam de aici, din zona asta, se trage dulcimerul.
So the dulcimer is coming from this area.
Okay, and can you also maybe tell me a bit about how you started to play this instrument? I'm very curious because for me, the dulcimer is a very unknown instrument. So I was wondering, how did you start to play this instrument?
Okay, a fost destul de simplu. Sunt născut într-o familie de muzicieni.
It was pretty simple because I was born into a family of musicians.
Muzica și instrumentele muzicale erau pretutindeni în jurul meu.
Music and musical instruments were everywhere around me.
Printre aceste instrumente exista și un cimbal.
And there was a cimbalom too.
Și mi s-a părut mai un instrument de joacă față de celelalte instrumente.
For me, at that age, because I started at 4 years old, was very, it was an instrument very...
A toy.
It was a toy. It's like a toy for
like
me.
Like a toy. Pentru că în timp ce consumam energia și dădeam cu bețele, ieșeau și niște sunete.
In the time when I hit the cymbalum and the strings, the sounds come out.
Yeah. Oh, so it started as a kind of a toy for you when you were 4 years old. Do you still see it as a kind of a toy you enjoy playing and you never, you are never sick of playing it? It's like, does it still feel like that moment when you were a child while playing it?
Încă îl simți ca o jucărie pentru tine și îți aduce aminte de copilărie atunci când mai cânti și acum?
Nu m-am îndepărtat de acest feeling.
Yes, it's still in my memory and I never give up these feelings.
Pot spune că sunt un privilegiat al vieții.
I can say that life... everything's around me and this instrument, it's a privilege for me.
Pentru că nu am muncit niciodată.
Because I have never worked.
M-am jucat tot timpul.
Every day was playing for me.
Like a child.
Yeah, I envy your passion. I wish I had something in my life, like I'm so passionate about it. And it already started when you were such a young child. So you already told me that your family also played music a lot. What is the role of music in the Romanian culture?
Foarte mare, la fel ca în oricare altă cultură, muzica cred că este driverul culturii popoarelor.
It is very important.
Este foarte important pentru că
it is very important because
muzica cred că fiind cea mai aproape de oameni dintre toate artele.
Music is the most closer art near people.
Okay. I have also a question. Sorry, you need to correct me if I don't pronounce it right. You had a project called Shiftisa. Do I pronounce it right? I don't know.
Yeah, it's okay.
And you won an award for it. And I started to read a bit about the project and I really liked the concept. Can you maybe tell me briefly what the project is about? And is it really also about presenting the beauties of Romanian people and culture?
Este un proiect dedicat femeilor românce.
It is a project inspired by the tales of the Romanian woman about the identity of a Romanian woman.
Este dedicat reginei Maria.
It is dedicated to Queen Mary of Romania.
Și vorbește de tipologii feminine, portrete de femei.
In this project, I'm talking about typologies of women, portraits from women.
Portrete de tinere fete, de adolescente.
Portraits from the teenage girl in love.
Portrete de femei îndrăgostite.
To the loving woman.
De femei părăsite.
To the widowed women.
De mame, femei
mother,
mame.
Mother women.
Tipologie de femei.
All kinds of typologies.
That is so soothing, especially since it's March and it's International Women's Month, I always say. I really like that concept. I'm going to delve deeper into it when I'm done with my work today, because it really sounds like a nice project. So I did a bit more of a research and I noticed a very energetic video online of you performing music with your son on stage. And you already told me that music played a big part in your family. How did you brought music in your own family? And is it something you bring over from one generation to the other generation? I really am curious about that.
văzut un video de-al tău cu Lorin și întrebarea este dacă transmiți din generație, de la o generație la alta, această...
Da, nu e obligatoriu chestia asta, transmiterea.
It's not quite necessary to transfer.
Muzica se face dacă ea te cheamă.
You make music if she's asking you to do it.
Dacă au o chemare spre așa ceva, pot alege singur.
They can choose their own to do it.
Că nu este necesar să se transmită din generație în generație.
It is not quite necessary to transfer from one generation to another.
Da, so se pare că nu există om care să nu vrea să facă muzică.
But seems that I don't think there are not people who do not want to do music.
To make. Yeah.
Okay. I really love that video. I was also wondering if you're also at home doing that kind of energetic performances. I really enjoyed it.
Yeah, it's the same.
Every day.
Same with the same passion.
That sounds so lovely. I imagine your home life there is amazing and always a bit of a party. Marius, you studied songwriting and film score at the Berklee College of Music in Boston, and you have composed movie soundtracks for Romanian films or TV shows, and also you wrote scores for theater. What did attract you specifically composing music for cinema and theater?
Compoziția muzicală este de două feluri.
The music composition has two different way.
Primul,
two kinds of music.
Primul fel este muzica absolută.
The first one is the absolute music.
Muzica pe care o compui ținând cont de propriile tale idei, ținând cont de propria ta imaginație.
Where the composer is influenced by his own vision and ideas.
Și muzica complementară, muzica care îți este inspirată de alte lucruri din jurul tău.
And there is a complementary music where the composer must merge with other types of art to complement the emotion that is to be transmitted.
Muzica de film este o muzică complementară.
Film music, it's a complementary music.
Ce vine să pună în valoare ideile altora.
It comes to put in value
another type of idea.
From other people.
From other people, for movie, for picture.
Okay. Images.
Images, yeah.
It also, I think, this also shows that music specifically is another form of storytelling, because you can invoke certain kind of feelings or emotions that might be difficult with words or verbal language. Can you maybe tell me more about the process of writing music scores for movies? What do you usually start with when composing? Do you have like a story in your mind?
Primul lucru pe care îl depistez este emoția filmului, ceea ce îți transmite filmul.
The first thing that you have to identify is the emotion of the movie.
The feeling.
Okay.
Acestea pot fi dragoste, tristețe, tensiune, bucurie.
These feelings could be love, sadness, tension, joy.
În moment ce ai depistat acest lucru, după aia te îndrepți către locație și timpul filmului.
After that, you start to see the location and the time when the action takes place in the movie.
Dacă faci, dacă filmul se petrece la Paris.
If the movie is in Paris, the action of the movie is in Paris.
Atunci ar fi bine să ai o muzică cu acest specific ca ascultătorul imediat să asocieze muzica cu imaginea.
Then you should write music from that period, from Paris, because the what the people have to see that atmosphere from Paris.
Yeah. Dacă ai un un film de locație și se desfășoară în perioada medievală.
If you have a medieval movie, yeah.
Da.
From that period?
Ar fi bine să vii cu o muzică din acea perioadă tocmai pentru a face conexiuni.
You should write music from that period.
So no electric guitar.
Exactly, no electric guitar.
Yeah.
Trebuie să știi ce instrumente erau în acea perioadă.
You have to know what kind of instruments they play in that period.
Care erau culorile sunetelor.
Which was the color of that instrument that they used in that time.
Da. Și atunci, atunci avem o muzică de, de locație.
And then you will see time music.
Time music.
So you are like a composer, an artist, but you are also a music historian. That's to say, if you there's a lot of research going into it, sounds like it. And the relation between music and other forms of art, such as cinema, is increasingly becoming important. How do you see the relationship yourself, and in how far do you feel does music relate to other senses than hearing alone?
Ce fel de emoții și lucruri le simți atunci când le...
Nu trebuie să simt eu emoții, ci tot timpul trebuie să mă pun în postura publicului. Trebuie să știu exact ceea ce vrea publicul să simtă.
I always have to think about what people want to feel. And it's very to work with images and to work with emotions and to try to help people feel emotion through that music that you are doing.
Acolo unde imaginea nu poate transmite suficientă emoție, acolo intervine muzica.
Where image fails to convey emotion, here music intervene.
That's so lovely. I can remember when I was a student, we had a discussion about classical music is not that popular anymore for many of the younger generation, but somehow there's always an interest in film music, and I really like that that it's so alive among people. People recognize music, songs, and soundtracks. So I think it's a really nice area to work in. So I really like that. So Marius, during your career, you have performed on various stages in the world, such as in Europe and the USA. You also had a lot of collaborations with renowned musicians in the music industry. With the current pandemic in mind, big projects such as these are put on hold, as creating music together physically is not really possible. How did you as a musician experience the trouble COVID's caused in terms of restricting creating music with other musicians together?
E destul de dificil să colaborezi cu muzicieni online.
It is a little bit, of course, difficult to work with a musician online.
Pentru că muzica și arta se bazează pe feeling. and primordial.
Because the music and art in general, it's based on feelings.
Trebuie să simți energia partenerului tău.
You have to feel the energy from the other musician.
Pentru că atunci se naște arta. Acela este momentul în care se naște arta,
because,
creației.
Because that is the time when the art is born.
Prin online există această barieră.
If we we are thinking about online, there is a screen between us, da. And the feelings are not the same.
Ce împiedică crearea unui act artistic desăvârșit.
And of course, it's not the same thing like you are in life.
Okay, that's another thing I want to touch upon, because when you play for a live audience or with other musicians, as you said, there is a kind of magic happening between the musicians or the musician and the audience, and that kind of feeling is lost. Do you think there's the same artistic trust between musicians online as when it is in the same physical space or room? Do we still trust the other musician?
În general, lumea muzicii e una singură.
Generally, the world of musicians and the music, it's just one.
Just one. Ne recunoaștem între noi.
We know each other.
Comunicăm între noi foarte bine, pentru că limbajul este universal.
The language is unique and
universal.
It's like a language of its own.
Yeah.
Evident că o colaborare online este total diferită față de una face to face.
Online collaboration is, of course, it's different, like face to face.
Nu cred că se pune vorba de încredere.
I don't think we have to talk about trust.
Dar evident că avem o problemă de comunicare și de schimb de energie.
But of course it's a problem of feelings that we transmit each other.
Yeah. Okay. The change energy.
Yeah. Okay, so Marius, you're invited by Lizabett Russo, also from Romania, and Graeme Stephens, the musicians behind the project Ensemble Eòrpa, and they wrote the album in keeping with the styles of the musicians involved in mind. Can you draw maybe on your own creative process from receiving the musical score to eventually recording and playing your musical part?
Cum ai primit
un proiect extrem de interesant, m-a capturat încă de la prima audiție.
It is a very interesting project who got my attention from the first notes.
Îmi place foarte mult să combin culturile diferitor popoare.
I like very much to combine the music styles from different kind of
culture
from people.
Și m-am simțit foarte bine că în acest proiect a putut intra și cultura muzicii românești.
And I was very proud that they choose me to get in this project and to be a part of this project.
Same goes all the way around.
Yeah.
L-am înregistrat acasă la mine, practic, în câteva ore, pentru că m-am simțit foarte bine în el și imediat am avut inspirații.
Because I like it so much, I recorded in some kind of, I don't know, some hours at my home studio.
Oh, sorry. that sounds very exciting, because I wanted to ask, where did you record the score? And you have your own home studio, so that is a plus, I think, because I also spoke to musicians who didn't have a home studio, so they had to ask their friends and their network to help them out. So that's pretty cool that you have your own home studio. Is there, I've already asked this one. So Ensemble Eòrpa strives to foster global connection through music and encourages new creative relations. What I ask every musician during these talks is, do you think that this way of remotely making music together will have an impact on the way musicians perform with each other in the post-corona era? And what about the dialogue between the musician and the audience?
Este unul dintre cele mai frumoase proiecte pe care le particip anul.
It is the most beautiful project that I'm in this year.
Pentru că exact cum spuneam mai devreme, muzica are un singur limbaj.
Because music has only one language.
Și ar fi minunat ca noi muzicienii să colaborăm între noi pentru a ne pune în valoare propria noastră cultură.
And I'm totally agree that all we musicians, we have to work together and to put our culture in front of all people.
All people. Yeah.
That's so lovely to hear. I was wondering because I had already a kind of preview of the music and I also spoke with all the other musicians. I wonder, are there musicians that you already collaborated with, or is it also a very big surprise for you who the other musicians are?
Este o surpriză pentru tine să vezi cu cine ai colaborat, știi cu cine ai colaborat, pentru că ea a ascultat deja.
Eu n-am ascultat materialul final.
I don't know the final material. I didn't hear it.
Știu doar ce am făcut eu.
I know what I made.
Și am avut câteva instrumente.
I had a few instruments.
Dar materialul final încă nu l-am ascultat.
But the final material I didn't hear it.
Oh, so it's going to be a surprise for you then, just as it is for me, I guess. Well, that's pretty exciting that you work on a musical project without even really knowing what the end result is going to be. So, yeah, exciting. What I always ask at the end of these talks is, Marius, I really enjoyed talking to you, and I think you had an amazing music career already behind you. I don't want to say that. You still have a very nice music career. And I was wondering if you could recommend your favorite album or your favorite piece of music to me or the people who are listening?
In generally or my music?
It can be your music, it can be general, it can be both. I'm happy with everything.
Dacă poți să-i recomand o muzică.
Avem mulți artiști și multe muzici în cap, nu știu pe care să vă spun.
I have a lot of artists and mentors in my head right now.
În materie de pop music, Sting, un om pe care eu l-am studiat în școală.
Sting? Did I write that? Sting? Like, yeah. The Police?
Sting, yeah. The Police, yeah.
Nice.
Sting, Joe Mayer, it's another musician.
Joe Mayer, okay.
Chicorea in jazz, Hiromi, in jazz,
rock.
In rock.
Metallica, yeah.
Metallica.
Yes,
I know what I'm going to do after this meeting.
Metallica.
A lot of artists. It's impossible to choose one. Okay, thank you for the list. I want to thank you also, Marius, for sharing all these thoughts on the creation of the project, of your career, And I also want to thank your wife, Arabella. You are a wonderful translator. Maybe I will hire you for a few purposes when I talk to my Romanian friend. No, she can speak English, by the way. But
you have to learn Romanian.
Sorry?
You have to
come to Romania and learn some words in Romania.
I only know your projects. Wait, what was it? Suftisa. That's the only Romanian word I know. Well, maybe give me 5 years and maybe I can speak it fluently. I also want to thank the audience who are listening back home or watching us via YouTube. I hope you all are doing well despite these weird times you are living in. And yeah, have a wonderful day and best wishes from Scotland, I say. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you.